Hi, in this video we are going to see about difference between microprocessor and microcontroller. Please find in description our WhatsApp group link and blog link and also other useful stuffs. Okay, we'll quickly move on to tutorials. Are you a developer or a tester or even a student? But you have to be aware of about the chip that you are going to use. Yes, because you may develop a program or you may flash your program for testing into the chip. But you have to understand and aware what the chip is, whether it is a microprocessor or a microcontroller or whatever it may be, or what is the main difference between both of these two. Yes, well, quickly see, this is microprocessor and this is microcontroller. Can you see any difference in these? Definitely no. By looking at this, you cannot able to see any difference. See, even the same microprocessor microcontroller have been put into the PCB, but still there is no difference in terms of visual. But yes, there is a difference between the both microprocessor and microcontroller. Not a single difference. You have n number of differences that if you are looking to the specifications. Yes, before that, have you remembered these questions? What is microprocessor and microcontroller? Can you tell me the difference between microprocessor and microcontroller? You might face the same question in your Viva Voice in your college days or even in your interview, but you may escape or you may not give a proper answer. But now you are in a corporate, that in your discussion you should be aware and you should be very clear in the point and the terms what you are in. Yes, so yeah, I don't want to waste more time. So microprocessor is simply a chip which consists of control logic, that is the logical operations can be taken care here, then ALU, arithmetic and logical unit, and registers. So what are the calculations have been done in the control logic and ALU, that is mathematical calculation can be done in the ALU. So what are the control law, what are the calculations have been done in both the components can be stored temporarily in register, that is called registers. So in microprocessor we have only these three major components have been present, but whereas in microcontroller, see, in microcontroller a microprocessor have been put into that, and apart from that RAM, ROM and IO have been added. So you can say the microcontroller is the next version of microprocessor. So the difference is very simple. See, microprocessor have only the, it can only calculate, it can do some basic calculations, it can store temporarily. But if you want to retrieve or if you want to have a communication with the external world, then microcontroller comes into the picture. Yes, so these were the main difference. So you know, you should not give a silly answers like, yeah, microprocessor is used to processing and controller is to controlling. It's not a the dumb answer you should not give. So you should give the answer that microprocessor is a single chip which contains control logic, that is some processing components with the register, whereas in microcontroller we have the other peripherals can be connected like RAM, ROM or other IO peripherals. Yes, this is a simple diagrammatic explanation, whereas we go into somewhat deeper in a theoretical ways that it should be very clear. Still, a microprocessor is just a processor or a single chip, contains registers, accumulator, ALU, inbuilt memory, program memory, data memory, etc. Where if we want to connect any device, say if we want to communicate the external world to process, then we need a PPI, that is a programming peripheral interface, that should have a ports that should be connected to this IC, that is nothing but microprocessor. If we need more and more stuff like interrupt controller, timer, flash, watchdog timer, DAC, etc., then you have to use an individual IC for everything. That will more, that will make you more costlier than if you are miniaturized the entire thing. Yeah, for example, that's a very simple example and easily understandable example for microprocessor is personal computer. Yes, in personal computer you can do gaming or you can watch movies, you can listen to music, you can edit photos, videos or whatever stuff you want. You can, yes, you can run any applications. Everything can be done in the microprocessor, whereas microcontroller, see, you can do only a specific operation, for example a vending machine, washing machine, microwave oven, everything. Oh yeah, before that, instead of using these many components to be connected in my microprocessor, I can rather use microcontroller That is, I can simply purchase one microcontroller at very minimal price and a minimal size, where the application have been predefined, so that the microcontroller will become acts like microcontroller equal to microprocessor plus IO plus interrupts plus timers and other circuits whatever we want to use. Example, washing machine, vending machine. Yeah, so I can give you the very two short statements that what is microcontroller and what is microprocessor. Yeah, microprocessor is nothing but a single chip contains a ALU, a logic, then there is logic circuit, then a register. In micro, whereas in microcontroller, the microprocessor will be there, then RAM, ROM and other ports and other peripherals also will be available. Yes. Apart from the first statement over, and second statement is the microprocessor is generic for me. You can do many applications in the microprocessor, whereas in microcontroller you can do specific operations, or it is designed for specific applications. So in this I have not mentioned any specifications I have not mentioned, but the very simple term I have been explained for your better understanding. That I, as you know, I don't want to make you more complex and make you more clumsy on stuff. Just know the basics, just aware of that, then you can go in deep. If you want more tutorials on microprocessor and microcontroller in terms of specifications, please leave a comment. And as per our previous quote, we have a interview QA discussion will be on our next tutorial. So if you have any personal experience that you want to share in your with respect to interview, you can leave a comment that what are the questions you have struck and what are the questions you made silly, or what are the serious questions, or what are the questions or answer. You can leave a comment that we'll put in a video, and that would be more interactive too. Yeah, if you like, please like and share to your friends and subscribe for more updates. Catch you in the next video.